God, I'm sitting here, trying to breathe, but I feel like my lungs are tied up. Like there's this weight pressing down on my chest, making it difficult to take another breath. There's so much happening in the world. I don't know how to tell the difference between what's false or true, fake or real, evil or good. My eyes have seen things unwillingly. My ears have heard things they shouldn't have. I feel ashamed, dirty, broken for the things that just appear on my feed. I don't know what to do. I don't know what to feel. COVID has changed many things in the world, and it's even affected people close and dear to me. Will this last forever? Will my kids one day see this? Live through this like I've had to? Day by day, we are consumed, absorbed, devoured, controlled and manipulated with what's going on out there, forgetting to be aware of what's happening here, your heart, your mind. Like dangling a carrot in front of a donkey, the world has convinced us that social media will satisfy every need and desire, promising knowledge but delivering shallow truth like smoke in a mirror, promoting deep fulfillment but delivering a moment of dopamine only setting you up for your next scroll fix. Our hours have become consumed by thumb wars, scrolling and scrolling as our phone screens light up our faces with what seems to be wonder and awe, but is actually just awful weakness. The online world says don't be fearful while feeding us anxiety on this golden spoon, not realizing that addiction is taking root like a weed planted in good soil. The more we scroll, the deeper the root. Facebook, Facebook, tell me how my life should look.
This is about our lives. We want our life to resume.
The previously reported cases, there are 11 COVID-related deaths in the country at this time.
Places and spaces that don't even know their own. So we end up buying things we don't want or need, with money that we do not have, to look like someone we were never meant to be, as we post pictures of our new life, trying to impress all the likes, comments and shares from people we don't even know, unknowingly putting on a mask. A facade of perfection, repeating the cycle of identity in question. So break the cycle of being misinformed about you, who you are and who you are meant to be. Stop saying Instagram, Instagram, tell me who I really am. Instagram did not create you. If you want to know the product, then get to know the manufacturer. Put down your phone, call the father, pick up the word and look no further. Clear your mind and put social media to rest. Keep looking to God and become your best.
But we can only do so if we all play our part.